Yeah, let's continue with the fully differential OPAMP. Okay, so actually this is not fully differential OPAMP. I want to skip it. See, just a single-ended OPAMP version. I want to skip that part. Okay, fully differential OPAMP. Yeah, so I have a two input node, two output node. So it's easy to cascade a fully differential OPAMP. It's very strong to supply noise because the supply noise is a common mode noise. So they are rejected at the following stage. Okay. Yeah, see, this is a folded cascode, a fully differential OPAMP, right? I added those things to avoid the slew period. Slew period, those transistors goes into very low potential. They fall into triode because of a current shortage. So I supply huge current from this voltage source to avoid those triode operation. Okay. So what's my CMF? Oh yeah, this is my rail-to-rail fully differential OPAMP. I think you have a homework, something like that. So I have a NMOS input and the PMOS input. And then, see, I have a fully differential output, right? You can make it single-ended version. See, if I have something like that. If I connect it like that. So this is my output. Then you can make a single-ended version, okay? But here, see, I want to make a fully differential output, so I need a CMFB circuit to drive this node voltage. Yeah, this is actually, input common mode ranges. Yeah, for this NMOS one, this is VDD, VSS. My ICMR is around that range, right? What is the PMOS input? My ICMR is around that range. So, yeah, in any case, I have some active input pair from VSS to VDD. This is called rail-to-rail. Rail-to-rail input op-amp. This rail is VSS rail to VDD rail, okay? My ICMR covers rail to rail. All right. Rail to rail이면 좋지. 보통 OPAMP는 input 범위가 내가 예를 들어서 1V짜리 OPAMP를 supply가 1V다. 근데 내 입력 범위가 내 그런 0.3에서 0.6V밖에 ICMR이 아니다 하고 0에서 1V짜리를 한다. 레일 투 레일이다. 그럼 얘가 훨씬 넓잖아. 동작시킬 수 있는 범위가 넓어지죠. 인풋, 커먼 모드 범위가. 그러니까 서프라이 볼티지를 다쓸수 있잖아. 맞습니다. 요 겹쳐지지 않은 부분은 이 GM을 따져보면은 GM이 얘는 NMOS GM밖에 없어. 요쪽은 겹쳐진 부분에는 자기 GM이 게인이 약간 달라져요. PMOS GM이고 얘는 PMOS GM밖에 없어. 이 전체 트랜스컨덕턴스가 좀 달라져요. 그래서 ICMR이 여기 있을 때는 게인이 좀 커. 이 앰프 게인이 커져요. 요즘 앰프 게인이 좀 작아. 그럼에도 불구하고 피드백 루프 게인에 걸면 거의 비슷해져 버려. 루프 게인 값이 좀 달라져 있긴 하지만 각각이 충분히 크면 얘도 막 충분히 크다고 생각하면 피드백 걸면 표가 별로 안 나. 약간만 나지 약간. 루프 게인이 좀 차이 나죠. 그래서 여기 뭐 그거 안 하기 위해서 GM을 확 키우는 것도 있고 그런데 그건 뭐 생략합시다. Okay, this is OTA, class AB OTA. I want to skip that. This is not, yeah, this is class AB. Yeah, let's talk briefly about the concept of a class AD. Yeah, you heard about the class AD op-amp in electronic circuits. Say, class A op-amp. Yeah, this is actually output stage. Yeah, VDD VSS here. Yeah, there is some current bias here. So if you connect it like that, this is my load. Yeah, this is class A. Yeah, the efficiency of class A, the efficiency of current driving load resistor versus the supply current of the entire circuit, yeah, it's 25%, right? Something like that. Class D is something like yeah, this is my class B. Yeah, this class B is I'm not sure exactly. It's around 60% or something like that, 67 or something like that. Eh? Yeah, so see, this is a zero. So when it's positive, it just drives like that. When it's negative, it drives like that. So it increases the efficiency, power efficiency. Class AB, see, there is some crossover distortion, right? If this voltage plus minus 0.7, say it's just a zero, right? That's a crossover distortion. So I put some little current here, some two diode there, and then VI. Then I don't have that crossover distortion, and then my efficiency is just slightly less because of power consumption of this part. Yeah, that's a class AB. Class AB is when VI equals zero. See, this is I think this is a minus, and this is a plus, and I have some middle level which is ground. Eh? So this is something. There is some load like that. If this voltage is zero, same as this middle level, I have only little current flows in this op-amp. But when this VO is large and positive, there is a huge current flows. So it increases the efficiency like a conventional class AB op-amp, okay? So my differential input is zero. See, those are two inputs, right? If they are the same, if my differential input voltage is almost zero, this VDD flows only little current. When this has a large difference, like a slew period, okay, it flows a huge current to the output, and then it just ramps up this voltage very quickly. That's class AB, okay? So during slew period, it flows a large current. During the steady state, with almost zero differential input, it flows very little current. Okay? Yeah. Whose turn? Oh, Kingwangmin, you ask a question. No? So I want to skip this part. Okay, those are class AB, one pop. PMOS switch, I mean CMOS switch, NMOS switch, right? This may be too large. You can reduce even this capacitor very small, like 0.1 picofarad. Ooh, looks like I finished chapter 10. You can present your homework on Monday also, if you want.